Junior Guy, GhostBillRiderAthletics.com, here with head men's basketball coach Andy Sharp in the aftermath of a 64-62 win for the Mule Riders in conference play over Harding University. Coach Harding, obviously, we talked about it a couple of days ago in our coaches show. A very disciplined team, well coached. So a great win for you and your team, obviously, in conference play. It was really a nail-biting game. They were able to surge ahead a little bit in the first half, were knocking down a lot of threes, but your team is able to battle back there at the end of the half, and then in the second half, you get a lead and kind of swell it out a little bit. They fight back, tie it there towards the end. Let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the closing sequence of the game. Got out, Harding's on offense, they're driving down. Probably the biggest block of the year this early year for Alrique Brown to knock it away, deny it, keep it tied. And then he comes down on the other end, gets a turnaround shot to fall inside the paint. And then, you know, they get the ball back, call a timeout. Suddenly, 0.5 seconds is put back up on the clock. Just enough time to get off, you know, a last-second prayer. Tyrell Taylor with a big block. So two key defensive stops for your team there at the end. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, you know, our guys, you know, the first half, we didn't execute defensively how we talked all week about executing against Harding. You know, they're a little different than everyone else we play in our conference in the fact that everyone's skilled and can dribble and shoot and pass. You know, so even their 6'10 kids out there shooting threes and things like that. So they made 8 threes in the first half, and a lot of that was from our own doing. You know, we took some poor shots, we had some poor possessions offensively. That led to transition threes for them. And the second half, I was really pleased that we kind of dug back in and played really well defensively. I thought maybe our best defensive effort of the year. And that sequence down the stretch with, you know, Alrique was in foul trouble a lot tonight. And I thought Alvin Braddock came in and played a big role for us tonight, like we know he's capable of doing. But that last sequence there with Alrique, and we've been trying to beat it into his head, you don't have to try and block every shot. And I'm glad he tried to block that shot and got it. And I thought we were going to get a whistle there. You know, I thought they were going to call an offensive foul on him, but luckily they let us play there down the stretch and let us decide it. And hats off to our guys for executing what we were trying to do.
You can talk about defensively in the second half playing better. You hold Harding to 32%. They were 40% in the first half. Only 2 of 11 from 3 in the second half. So that speaks to, you know, you're just talking about how your team made some defensive stops. And let's talk about Alvin Braddock. He wound up with a very impressive double-double, 16 points, 14 rebounds, 10 of those rebounds coming on the defensive glass. You know, obviously coming into the year, he was a guy that you were looking to be that presence inside. But, he, you know, unfortunately, first minute of the season, breaks his nose, is out for a couple of games. Now he's wearing a protective mask. Still kind of getting used to that. It's his second game, but you know, this is any indication what he can maybe play with that mask, getting used to it, this is kind of the Alvin Braddock you were expecting, right?
Yeah, I think he got everyone's attention tonight. You know, Alvin is a bouncy 6'5", 6'6", well-put-together athlete. You know, he was a second-team All-American in junior college. He averaged a double-double, you know, played in the JUCO All-Star game in Vegas. So he's done a lot in his short time in college, and thankfully, you know, we were able to get him somewhat used to that mask. You know, Matt, our athletic trainer, shaved down that padding and got it a little more comfortable, I think, for Alvin. And you know, he's just a force. You know, he's kind of reckless with his body. He'll throw his body around and go be bouncy and just he rebounds out of his area. You know, coaches can find anybody to rebound in their own area. When you get kids that are willing to go outside of their area and go stay in plays and keep plays alive and things like that, that really gives your team a boost, you know, with getting extra possessions on offensive rebounds or running down a big long rebound there late in the game like he did. You know, so Alvin really played well. I think he's kind of snake bit at the free throw line like everyone else is right now, going 9-for-27 as a team. Isn't going to beat a lot of people. So if we can shore up our free throw shooting and continue to play offensively and defensively how we did tonight, you know, we've got a chance to do something this year.
You know, one other thing noticing in the lineup, you had Jerron and Tyrell on the court at the same time, two point guards out there, so a little bit more of a smaller lineup. Kind of what did that kind of do for you offensively, and You know, what did you see out of that combination on the court?
Yeah, you know, after we played Commerce, we felt, you know, we started Alvin and Enrique against Commerce, and they were really big. You know, but I think starting DJ at the four kind of gives us an advantage because he's difficult to guard for a big guy to get out and guard him on the perimeter. And DJ does a lot of good things going and attacking the rim. And so we feel like that's an advantage we need to try and exploit right there. And it also opens up the middle for Alvin and Enrique to have more room. I thought everyone saw tonight the ball movement we had was much crisper and lots of passes on possessions, and we shared the ball. And as opposed to being three out, two in like we were prior to this game, we went four out, one in, and we're able to spread things out and get some good action. You know, so hopefully we can continue to roll with that lineup. I think having Jaron and Tyrell on the floor together is difficult to stop when you got two guys that can break you down. You can rebound an outlet either way, get down the floor quickly. So I liked our lineup tonight.
We appreciate it very much for your time. Again, that's head men's basketball coach Andy Sharp. Mule Riders with a big win, 64-62 over Harding at the W.T. Watson Center. Another big conference game coming up in a couple of days from now on Saturday against Ouachita Baptist. That game will set to tip around 4 o'clock or shortly after the women's game, which starts at 2. Coach, appreciate it.
Thanks.